guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys doing? I have a hot topic today, like hot juicy topic. I was on Instagram. When I tell you guys that Instagram is not just for seeing top girls, all these bougie girls, you can actually get some inspiration from there. That's what happened to me. I stumbled on this post and I was like, I need to film a video about this to let out my opinions and to hear what you guys have got to say. I just thought this topic was too juicy to pass on, so I'll just go ahead and read what this lady posted. She said, okay, so there's an argument going on at home. I want my Twitter fam to put mouth. In a situation where both mothers of a couple are alive and the wife gives birth, which of the mothers is supposed to come and take care of the baby and the lady? Wife's mother or husband's mother? There are 1,070 comments under this post. I'll read a few of the comments and then I'll tell you guys what I think, waiting to read your comments to hear what you think as well. So the first comment was, wife's mother, of course. If the husband's mother comes, the wife will have high tendencies of having postpartum depression. Okay. The girl's mother first, the boy's mother can visit later. End the debate now. Ha, I was like, Jesus. Somebody else said, can both come please? Take turns carrying my child while I sleep all day and nurse my sore vajayjay. I don't have strength, bikon. I was like, Jesus is Lord. Somebody else said, it's my mother, so I can send her to do anything. Okay. And let me see. Good. I love this comment in particular because that's absolutely my point of view as well. It says, anybody that can bath my baby before I wake up, make me food 3 times daily during that period, and can do laundry too. Anybody, please. I just born a beg. No headache. I absolutely agree. And somebody else said, why can't they come together? Whoever made these rules was high on some shit that time. So that's it. There are so many comments. If I have to go through the comments, you guys will laugh out your lungs. Somebody else said, the one that is jobless amongst them. But if both of them are jobless, the wife's mother. Okay. So that's it. When I saw this, I was like, yes, this is a bigger topic. I need to talk about this because I'm currently expecting. So what's my take on this? Should the wife's mother come first or the boy's mother? I'll talk about myself in this scenario. I'll just be straightforward and I'll speak my truth about it. So for me, I guess it absolutely makes sense when you just give birth. Maybe you want your mom is alive. I mean, those are one of the moments in your life that you really want, that you want, especially when you're a first time mom yourself. I've never bathed a newborn baby. I don't know how it's done. I may just be going through a lot of things that I wouldn't even know how to make sense out of them. It makes absolute sense that you want your mom. That I get. In my case, for example, to put it out there, my mother-in-law is coming first. Yeah. So my mother-in-law, maybe that's why this topic was too juicy for me. Oh my God, my earring keeps coming out. I call her my mother-in-law because we've got an amazing relationship. She's coming first, you see. So but the honest truth is, I spoke to my mom. I asked her, she's quite busy. I asked her like, can you come at this time, this is when I'm giving birth and stuff like that. My mom was like, no, she's not sure, she cannot get off work at that time, she's not sure she'll be able to come. I was like, okay, cool, no problem. So I spoke with my mother-in-law is available to come. So yes, my mother-in-law is coming first when I give birth. She's actually coming before I even give birth, since we just don't know what to expect and would want to have a maternal relation at home while I go through the last stage of giving birth. So my mother-in-law is coming. I'm ecstatic that she's going to be here. I'm so looking forward to her coming, assisting me and all of that. She's the most hardworking person that I know in my life. She doesn't mind to do anything. She wouldn't even wait for you to tell her. That woman will cook you 10 meals if you want. She will put you water to bathe if you need. Baby is going to be in the perfect hands. This little princess is going to be in the perfect hands with my mother in love, because that's the person that is coming first. So I guess my own opinion is unpopular, because I'm going to have my mother-in-law. It was not imposed on me. I'm absolutely ecstatic. I'm absolutely happy. And I cannot wait for her to get here. Like I said, she's really hardworking. She's going to be hands-on doing things. That woman can work for Africa. Like, she raised my husband. She raised an amazing man. I cannot wait for her to come. So yeah, in your own opinion, what do you think? Of course, she would come and then she would go back, and then my mom would come as well. But for those that said, why can both of them not come? Honestly, I'm of the opinion that I cannot handle two at the same time. Two of them. No, Nabiko. I cannot just handle two. Very soon, maybe one has an opinion. Maybe you should be rubbing Minyanga on the baby. The other mother will be like, no, maybe you should not. No, let me take one opinion at a time. Those times are stressful. I need somebody to take care of my baby. I need somebody to take care of me. I need to have peace of mind. I need to heal. The vajayjay would have to heal. I need somebody to help me go through that process peacefully. And in my case, it's going to be my mother-in-law first, and then my mom will come after. What do you guys think? What's your own opinion? Should the mother-in-law come first? Should the wife's mother come first? Like, if you were in my shoes, what would you want? Like, who do you want? I thought I'd film this video, just chit chat about it. It was so hilarious. When I read the comments, I kept laughing. I'll drop the Instagram page where I got this post from, so you guys can go check out the comments as well. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to click the subscribe button. It's somewhere. Let's grow the channel. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.